In addition to progress from across the HX50 and GT50 programme, we've obviously also been super busy completing the infrastructure build here at PC1. Let's have a quick wander around the facilities and I'll show you some of the major things that we've been completing. To start with, what you can see behind me here is the massive laminating shop that we'll be using to produce all of the HX50 fuselage composite components and blade components. This massive facility in the middle of PC1 is where we take the tools. We have the kit cutting machine for the carbon fiber kitting, and then we also laminate into all of the tools before they go over into the oven for curing, and then back into the trim shop for final trimming and prepping for paint. We've also now completed the trim shop here. We've got the roller shutter doors on that allow us to create a dust tight environment, allowing us to keep all of the dusty business of making patterns and trimming carbon fiber components all in here and away from the precision and clean operations elsewhere in PC1. In between the trim shop and the gantry mill facility, we've now installed our massive gantry crane. The purpose of this is twofold. Firstly, it enables us to lift the large scale block up materials and patterns and molds onto and off of the gantry mill via the concertina roof that allows us to load things onto the table. And then secondly, when we've completed the assembly of the prototype helicopters, then we can use this crane with a weighing attachment to weigh and manage the center of gravity of each unit that we produce. Let's go and have a look in the production control office. Welcome to the new production control centre here at PC1. Down here, every element of production of every part of GT50 and HX50 are controlled by Mark and his wider team. The production engineers that are based down here essentially write all of the programs to control the CNC machines, all of the quality control and inspection processes that are used in the metrology lab, and control every aspect of the production of every part that we make, all the way from goods inwards through to the flow of materials through the factory, through every process until we've got finished parts ready to be kitted and brought together into assemblies. The facility down here is totally self-contained. We've got all of the people that work on production based here, led by Mark, and then we've also got self-contained breakout meeting rooms to allow any problems that crop up day to day to be resolved quickly and efficiently. The cool thing about coming down here is you always get to see the next thing that's coming down the pike in terms of production. So over here, one of the things that they've been doing during the course of the last week is developing some finishing processes to get the surface finish on each of the turbine blades just where we want it for both the test engine and production applications. And then if you have a look over here, we've just taken delivery of the first three blocks of upholstery foam. This is the carbon based foams that are flame retardant and have the required comfort properties that we want. These are the foam blocks that we'll be making the very first seat trays and backrests out of for the first prototype crashworthy HX50 seat that's due to go on crash test very early next year. And then finally, if you have a look over here, we've just finished off the first couple of machine guards for the speed reduction gearbox test rig that we're building at the moment, ready to get module 4 of the GT50 engine on test towards the end of this year as planned. So always fun to see the bits that they've got coming together. Let's nip outside, I'll take you upstairs and we can go and have a look at all the new facilities that are almost complete up there too. So we're up on the first floor level above the machine shop, and all of the specialist facilities that we're putting together to handle predominantly assembly operations are now drawing to completion. So what you can see over here is what we call the mechanical assembly shop. So this is the area where the first GT50 engines will be put together, the first gearboxes and rotor heads will be put together, the first undercarriage assemblies will be put together, all of the build processes for those things developed and proven, and all of the tools and fixtures and jigs and equipment that we need to do that in full scale production proven out for the first time. I think we've got about a week or two left to get this facility completed. There's no lights in there at the moment. The lighting panels in the roof have just got to be dropped in. And then this is another area of PC1 that's ready to go. Let's have a look a bit further down here. The next facility is our in-house trim shop. So this is a development shop for all of the elements of trim that go into the helicopter. So the seats, the A and B pillar cappings, the carpet, and anything else really that we need to trim to give that quality feel. So in this environment here, again, we have a clean room environment where we can keep all of the dust and all of the many different activities separate in a nice clean environment to deliver a high quality product. Welcome to the PC1 glazing facility. So within this facility here, we essentially produce all of the windows and all of the interior trim panels for HX and HC50. We've got the oven that we've previously shown you there waiting to take up its final position in the corner of the room. And then within this facility, we'll be doing all of the drape forming of the impact resistant windows, and then all of the vacuum forming and drape forming of the other windows around the aircraft, the light lenses, and then also the interior trim panels that we use to clad the interior materials to give you that nice high quality finish that you've come to expect from your aircraft. One of the things that's immediately apparent when you stood up here on the mezzanine level is just how big the new laminating facility is that's required to produce all of the composite components for HX50. The other thing that's immediately apparent as well is just how quickly we've consumed this vast space building a factory that's able to produce every component of the aircraft and engine. The starter generator test rig is finally installed, commissioned, and we're ready to start testing of module one of the GT50 engine. The speed reduction test rig for module four will be completed by the end of the year as scheduled. We've completed testing on the final configuration of HX50's landing and navigation lights, and we've brought together all of the sensors and hardware required for a flying version of the DigiCockpit. In addition to that, we've now got everything under the one roof at PC1 to enable us to carry out the casting of high quality aerospace turbine blades and all of the other intricate components that we need to make for the engine. And we're in the final stages now of completing the build of the clean room environment for the flying HX50 fuselages.